Hello everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is Meera and I'm your study abroad advisor. I assist students in pursuing their higher education abroad and I have also assisted many students in pursuing their MBBS education abroad in various universities of various countries. And in today's video, I'll be talking about a very important thing, that is the new rules and regulations that has been published by NMC. And these new rules will be implemented for all the students who will be taking admission in 2021. This NMC actually says a lot, but we'll be discussing only those few important points which you all should know before you take the MBBS admission abroad. And there are certain things which have actually been changed when you compare it with the previous rules. The sole motive of this video is to interpret what exactly NMC is telling in this notification. Here we'll be discussing all the important points which you should know before you take the admission. And the link to download this notification is mentioned in the description box. All of you can download that notification and please make sure you read the entire notification, because it is very important that you have the entire information before you take the admission. What exactly does this NMC new rule say? So which are the students who will get the permission to register as a doctor in India? So you can check the clause 1, which says no foreign medical graduate shall be granted permanent registration unless he has undergone, the point number one, undergone a course leading to foreign medical degree with minimum duration of 54 months, which means a student who is seeking MBBS admission abroad should make sure that the university is offering you the course of minimum 4.5 years duration. The second point is, undergone an internship for a minimum duration of 12 months in the same foreign medical institution.
So if you actually see, not every country will offer you internship program from the same institution. There are many countries which offer either 5 years or 6 years MBBS program without internship. So this clause is again not in favor of the students for their admission.
And the other point is, undergone supervised internship in India for a minimum term of 12 months after applying for the same internship. Which means, even though if you do your internship program from abroad, you will again have to do your internship from India no matter what. As per the previous clause, as per the previous rules, and all the internship programs from abroad were accepted in India. Students needn't do any internship program in India if they have done their internship from abroad. But as per these new rules, student even after doing their internship from abroad will have to come back to India and do internship here. So that makes it double internship. Next important point is the location of your medical college. They say the entire course, training and internship or clerkship shall be done outside India in the same foreign medical institution throughout the course of study, and no part of medical training and internships shall be done in India. So previously, if you were not doing your internship from abroad universities, you were allowed to come back to India and do your internship here from India. But as per this new rule, you will have to take the admission, you'll have to complete your entire course, and you will have to do your internship also from the same institution. In case if that's not there, then your degree will be invalid. So this again is actually not in favor of the students, because there are so many countries which do not offer the internship program. They just have 5 years or 6 years of the course for the MBBS, but without internship. So this again is not, this is again a drawback for all the students. Last is duration of your course. The total duration of foreign medical graduation course shall be completed within 10 years, which means if you're taking admission now, you will have to complete your MBBS degree, MBBS program in next 10 years. So if you fail to get your degree within 10 years, then that becomes a difficult part, and your degree will not be valid anymore. So you have to make sure that you complete this MBBS program within 10 years, the day you take your admission. So these are very important points that you have to keep in your mind. So as per our quick review, I'll just say that if you are taking MBBS admission, your minimum course duration should be 4.5 years. You should have an internship program in the university that you take admission. and you should come back to India and do your internship again in India after you complete your degree from abroad universities. You have to complete your entire course with internship, your theory classes, your practicals and your clinical rotations, that is your internship from the same university. You will have to complete your entire MBBS degree within the time of 10 years. So these are the main highlights of this new rules that NMC has published. Talking about the applicability of these new rules and regulations, like who are the students who fall under this category? So for that, you can check the point number 5, that is applicability of these rules and regulations. That is, to candidates who are pursuing their education in foreign institutions prior to coming into force of these regulations, which means any student who have taken MBBS admission before this regulation was implemented, those students are free from this regulation. These new rules will not be applicable for those students. But any student who will be taking admissions from now, those students will fall under these rules and regulations. So they have to keep these regulations in their mind and only then take the MBBS admissions. So overall, if you talk about these new rules and regulations, I personally feel that it is not in the favor of the students, because not every country offers you the internship program. And after doing the internship from abroad, you will again have to come back to India and do that. That makes it double internship. Your course duration will actually prolong a lot. So this is my inference, and I feel there are many clauses that actually has to be challenged. So currently everyone is evaluating these new rules and regulations, and I personally feel that these rules actually has to be amended, because these are definitely not in favor of the students. So this was my interpretation about this new rules and regulation of NMC. Please do let me know in the comment section, what do you think about this new rules? Is it in your favor, or how happy or dissatisfied are you with these new rules and regulations? And what are your opinions? With that said, thank you so much for watching this video till the end, and make sure you subscribe my YouTube channel, because I'll be coming up with many videos where I'll talk about this MBBS, and we also will discuss further about this new rules and regulations of NMC. Till then, take care and thank you so much.